Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching Fluidity. Treble OS is the only custom ROM having essence of Pixel OS and Lineage OS. It's a pure AOSP ROM with the Pixel goodies and performance of both worlds. In the last video review of Treble OS, we introduced the first initial release of Android 16 based Treble OS. You can check its video review link given in iCard. You will also get the Android 15 based fully stable Treble OS review in the video description. Today we flash its new AOSP Treble Droid GSI build on OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2. We tested, does this new update really provide you stable GSI experience or not? We will check out the bug fixes done in this update in comparison with old build, and at the end we will see which bugs you may still encounter in this update. So don't skip any part of this video, watch it till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. New bug fixes and all update changes are similar for OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2, so I will only review this update on Poco X2. While some bugs are different for OnePlus 9RT in comparison with Poco X2, that you will find in a bug section of this video. My Poco X2 is too old and got lots of hardware issues like this screen burn at the bottom side. Still, I am enjoying the Android 16 on this older device. If you check its about device section, you will not find any BreezeOS logo here because the team released this build with new source code of Treble Droid AOSP Android 16. Security patches are updated to June 2025. This ROM will definitely boot on any device running with the permissive kernel version from 4.14 like my Poco X2. While kernel version above 5+ like my OnePlus 9RT have great potential to boot any kind of GSI build. Build date of this ROM is of 5th June 2025. While in quick setting panel, it's showing the build number of beta Android 16 version. It's BP2A 2506053131.A. These details will remain same for all GSI ROM except its kernel version. While custom ROM users' device details may differ for different devices. I am not going to review Android 16 feature in this video. For detailed review of all the features, you can check other video links given in the video description. This build fixes the Bluetooth issue of old BreezeOS build. It's working now. I tested it using my OnePlus Bullets earbuds and they are working fine in this build. The second release comes with the Pixel launcher, which have now working recent selection feature, which was not available in a previous build. So now you can share text, web links or images directly from recents menu. Next, this build by default have correct status bar icons and punch hole camera notch alignment for Poco X2. But you may face issue for this for other devices. I will show you that in a bug section of this video. Next, team have fixed the fingerprint issue for this build. Now fingerprint is fully working for Poco X2. But still some devices including OnePlus 9RT may get some issues. Next, only basic play integrity check got passed in this build, but because of inbuilt bootloader spoofing module of ROM, all banking applications are working fine for me. I tested almost all banking and payment applications in this ROM and all are working fine. Even DRM info level is L1, so you can run Netflix and Amazon like media streaming application at full HD resolution. Next, developer have improved the performance of this build to next level. So this ROM can be considered as one of the smoothest ROM I ever use. Scrolling, apps opening, switching between applications. And finally, the gaming is amazing on this ROM. Using BreezeOS makes you feel real breeze around you. But once you boot the ROM, you have to do one step. For that, go to the setting. And under the system and under the PHS table setting, of miscellaneous option, enable these two toggles. First one is disable SFHWC back pressure and second is disable SFGL back pressure. Both of these settings helps to improve the rendering performance of your devices. As BreezeOS have the essence of LineageOS, some default LineageOS applications like LineageOS music application called as Gramophone is available with its new user interface. ROM comes with the fully working LineageOS aperture camera application. Don't get confused with this photo application. It's not a Google Photo app. It's a Lineage OS Glimpses photo application. This ROM gives you nearly stable experience on Poco X2, but still there are some bugs like long press power button to evoke Google Gemini causing screen flickering. Light mode didn't give the complete light mode to QS panel. You can check here. Except the QS panel, other things like notification setting panel gets light mode instead of QS panel. As I already told in all my videos that different devices may react differently for GSR ROM because GSR ROMs are not developed for specific devices. They are generic. So you may get different bugs. Similarly, though on my Poco X2, this ROM can be considered as a nearly stable build. But on my OnePlus 9RT, I got issue of misalignment of status bar icons for punch hole camera. This time I didn't got any display cutout option in a developer setting, which helped me to solve these bugs in any kind of GSI ROM. Fingerprint is still not working in OnePlus 9RT. I think most of GSI have working fingerprint for device having physical fingerprint button, like Poco X2, while all under display fingerprint devices may get this issue. No face unlock is found in a security setting for both of Poco X2 and OnePlus 9RT. Issue of 2G calling is still present in both Poco X2 and OnePlus 9RT. LTE data network works perfectly, but calls may switch to 2G calling for both of devices. So what is my final verdict about this build of BridgeOS? This ROM is very good with goodies of PixelOS and LineageOS. It have lightweight experience, so any low-end device can handle this operating system. Some bugs are present in the ROM, but you can use it with the OC loader as a dual boot ROM along with your primary ROM. You can use banking application and can test Android 16 experience on your older devices. This is the power of open source Android development. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of such in-depth review of all custom ROM and GSI builds and Android mods for all devices. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.